I tell you something, today, if you were listening, children have a very big problem. I have a big problem, forget about the children, because I love toys. I was brought up to make my own toys, and I adore toys. Toys are the two things in life worth living for. One is the toy, and one is a cartoon. And then, if you like, you can play football. But the biggest problem with toys is, especially now, is this stupid batteries. You run out of battery, fun is over. And now, especially 9-volt batteries, we listen to what these guys told us today. Get a small nanowire and test this. See if it works. Battery forever. Anybody wants to try? I asked to test something, and it tells you, put a battery inside a GANS, and put a GANS inside the battery. Now start running. And then now, if I know I get home, I get a call from Alex. It happened. Now you put a wire on top of it. I don't know. I know what's going to happen, but you're going to tell me exactly what's going to happen. Do you know in Africa, there are a lot of batteries people can't use anymore? They repair and repair and repair. Now you can go any broken battery with a wire on it, put some GANS at the bottom of it, not even an acid, or if it's got acid, put some GANS on top of it. Acid doesn't touch certain GANSes, but it releases their energy. I've tried it. I've taken a battery acid trying to dissolve CO2. So maybe we can try. We don't need to charge a battery anymore. And understand is not, as I explained, this material is twisted. It's exactly like, adults will understand more maybe, it's a vortex. It's what they try to achieve in tokamak. You rotate. If you wind this correctly, you see a lot of benefits with it. So, the energy will flow up, and it feeds your motor. I want to know and check it tonight, see if I can run that little helicopter and not sit there and wait it to be charged up. But there is another way to do it. You have these little batteries, which has got only one little bit on top. No problem. You put one little on the top, and you know they always have a spring at the bottom. Now I'll call this spring. Ever Ready bankrupt. You know Ever Ready? Ever Ready batteries, they're South African. They tried to buy the technology and hide the technology. They flew in from South Africa. The battery energy side. But they're in the windmills as well. They're more interested in that. So now, would this create a condition of flow in your... But there's a problem. If you have a zinc-coated extension at the end of your spring, you stand a good chance. If it's a metal, it's very difficult. But still there is a way to do it, nano-coat the wire and twist it around the spring. You still get the same. I've tried this, it's amazing how it works. Don't forget when you come to the other lab, I'll show you for years I've played with this thing. If you remember, years ago, even last year, I used to show a torch with a nanowires. And the nanowires, if you looked in the body, they were twisted. It has a central column and a twist was on it. And if you put so many wires after each other, you create a current flow, 1.2 milliamps, plus 0.002 milliamps. And then you add pieces together. You can have a torch which runs on its own. I have 2 or 3. So now you see how simple life is becoming. Because you can gather, understand why, where the energy comes. The blackness is, as you saw, those layers we made, they are little gap creators. And the energy which comes from here, it goes and gets stored in the layers till you need it, and then it flows. The direction of the flow of the motor of the car shows which way you want to use it. So, no more need for batteries, rechargeable. Or you can make yourself a much easier, better battery. I've said this before. Just place the battery inside the plastic casing of the gas material. The energy of the gas will flow through the charger and it charges it without a need for the flow of absorbing through nanolayer. So all you need to do, you need to introduce the gas inside the layer. It's a reserve tank of energies and your acid inside of it.